New tonight, changes promised at this dangerous interchange are finally ready. We're learning about the efforts being made to stop drivers from running the red lights at I-225 in 17th place. And tonight, 7 News reporter Marshall Zellinger with the recovery of one of the crash victims.
Cock your wrist back up like this. Good. Are you able to extend your fingers? Not yet.
It's the side of a car crash you rarely see.
Now with this arm?
Sandy Mina, still rehabbing from a broken hip, dislocated shoulder, broken arm.
Good. You're improving significantly.
Compare that to September.
I have an injury on my neck.
When we met Sandy, she looked like this, badly broken when her SUV was T-boned by a driver who ran a red light at the new 17th place off-ramp at I-225.
Have you been through that intersection since?
No. I don't like to.
Sandy's accident was one of 7 since the interchange opened in February, where a driver ran the red light going west on 17th Place toward Fitzsimmons.
I really hope that they're working on something to prevent stuff like this from happening to other people, because it's not something I wish for anyone.
We have just seen that people come and make this turn that we're making right now, and even though that great big red light is right in front of them, they look down the road, they don't see that there's an intersection here.
We rode along with Aurora Police Lieutenant Jeff Turner to see what changes are coming.
There will be a sign that says signal or intersection ahead 200 feet with an arrow.
There will also be 2 other signs, a yellow traffic signal warning sign and a stop here on red sign.
3 more warnings that there is an intersection, there's a stop light, a signal there.
The signs are ready, just waiting to be put in place. Just like Sandy's bones.
It's definitely something I'm going to have to face for the rest of my life. It's worth it. I got a second chance.
In Aurora, Marshall Zellinger, 7 News.